Hey everybody, it's John. Welcome to the outside of the ham shack. As you can see here, this is something new that I've got for the shack, and that is bringing the antenna lead or the coax in through the wall. Now, previous to this, you may have seen the video, and if not, I'll link the video if you ever want to do this. I have a video to show you how to make this window board that actually fits down to the bottom. The window came on it. This served me well for about 3 years, but recently we put in some new windows here at the house, and I decided that I wanted something slightly more, or rather a lot more permanent than the pass-through. What I've done here is, and I'll start off by saying, I did not do the install as far as drilling the holes. I could have done that. I had an electrician come. I called around a little bit, and the base rate for an electrician here in Northeast Texas is $85 to come out for 1 hour. And I talked to him. He said, well, I can certainly drill a hole in the wall in less than an hour. So what I did, I had him come out and just drill the wall only, drill the hole only. Everything else I did, which was very easy to do. When we drill the hole, if you ever want to do this yourself, what he did, he just got this. Of course, it wasn't this size here, but it was the outside, which is 1.5 inch electrical conduit. Was the size that I used to go through the wall. All he did is he just put this up against the wall, took a Sharpie and went around the circumference of it, and then drilled 3/16 holes in a circle, then punched it out. Also had him do a few other different things, but I said at the end of the day, it took him about 45 minutes, and he kind of looked over this and said, yeah, that's exactly what I need to do. So that, the hole, and some advice along the way, again, was $85. I thought it was money well spent. The hardest thing, of course, is making the decision to drill through your brick wall. And once we decided that we were going to stay at this location for a while, I decided to go ahead and pull the trigger and just have that done. So once it was drilled into the wall, what I did, and all the electrician did was drill the hole. Everything else on the interior and the exterior, I had to do all that myself, which again was very easy to do and relatively inexpensive. Everything came from Lowe's. Once I got the hole drilled and after he had left, I went to actually do the inside, and that just took a hole drill in the sheetrock, and I'll go inside and I'll show you that in just a moment. Now what I did, I used it at a slight angle. I went up slightly as I went into the wall from the exterior to the interior wall, so in case I would get any rain that came through all the ceiling and the weather sealing that I'd done, at least it would continue to drip towards the outside. That may be something you would consider. Everything that I needed was just the about 2 feet of 1.5 inch electrical conduit, plastic of course, and then I had a junction box right here. This is just a box that makes a right angle, and then I had this box here, which is a 6x6 box. So, and then I had some couplings that are involved here, and then a couple of couplings down here on this side where the wire comes in. I'll show you what all's involved in it, and I'll bring the camera a little closer, and I'll kind of walk through a few things here on the outside. Again, this is a 6x6 box, and it's just empty on the inside when you buy it, and you have to drill your holes in. So I had to mark this out and drill it. It just was drilled with a regular hole saw, and this piece right here is just a junction box, and it's just made for where you make a right angle. Down here is where the antenna and the grounds are in there. Again, I had to drill these two holes right here at the bottom of it. As I said, the box itself has no holes at all in it. Down here you can see the ground wire. This is the ground wire from the lightning arrestor. I'll show you that inside the box in a moment. This wire right here is actually grounding the station equipment that's inside. It all runs down here to a ground rod. This right here is the ground coming in from the base of the antenna. This ground right here is running up to the service entrance, which is about 10 feet to the right of this pole right here. And this is an 8-foot copper clad ground rod. This is the coax that's coming in. It is a direct burial coax, and this is just some white PVC that I've got, and the coax is buried that comes to the side of this right here and comes on up a little bit and into the junction box. Now, I've already taken the screws off, so I'll go ahead and go and show you what's inside this box. Just as an FYI, the box is weatherproof. You can see the gasket down there. That's on the outside of it. Inside the box is a surge protector / lightning arrestor. Of course, nothing is a true lightning arrestor, but it does have a surge protector. Again, here's the ground that's coming off of it that goes down into the others. By the way, this just twisted up wire right here is just, that's just excess wire. The ground itself is a very secure and solid ground connection. There, everything is coming in right down here at the ground clamp at the bottom. The only thing that that I do have for an exterior entrance where bugs can get in are these two things right here, and I really don't have a good answer for that. Eventually I'm going to put silicone in here to stop everything up, but right now it's in the stages where I'm putting everything together, so I want to keep it to where I have access to put some more coax through there at another time. Also, I can drill a hole back in here and put another one of these. I can actually put two more of these in. There's space in the back to come in. If I ever need to get the box off, this part right over here just screws on. That's threaded. I can take these two things here, unscrew that, and the whole box itself will come off. I'm not going to take the cover off of this. This is just for a right angle so that it can make the turn. Here at the top of it, you can see some silicone. I've got it's the best silicone I could find, and it was recommended by some folks that this will really stick to brick and stick to that plastic, and it should not ever have any problem with it. You may decide to go with mortar. That would be your choice. That's the outside of it. Let's go to the inside, and I'll show you what the shack looks like on the inside next to the ham desk. Here's the inside of the ham shack that I was talking about. Of course, this is the pipe that comes inside. I put a little bit of white paint on it just to keep my wife happy for a few days until we determine what we're going to do next. I think what I might do is put a trim ring or something around here. The ham shack is actually inside of a closet, so it's not out in the open. It's not where people will see it on a daily basis. It's just some little space that I have right here. This is the coax that came through. This is the ground wire that comes from the grounding strip where all the equipment is grounded to. As you can see, it's pretty intrusive as it comes along the way. And again, I'm still at a loss as to exactly what I'm going to do to put in there. If you have any suggestions, put those in the comments below. And again, I've got it pretty bug-proof as I possibly can, but I would like to have it 100% bug-proof. And also, as I said a while ago, the pipe itself that comes through this conduit is actually on an elevation of about a half inch. Elevation from the outside wall to the inside, this is about a half inch higher. So in case there was a break in any type of silicone or any type of weatherproofing, the water would run outside the wall and not to the inside. Well, I hope you got some ideas there about how to put in your UHF or VHF antenna through your wall to go inside your ham shack. Again, it was relatively easy. The total cost was about $100. That took $85 for the electrician to come and put the hole in the wall. If you choose to do that yourself, of course, that would be subtracted from this. The materials themselves ran about $20. So around a $100 bill, you can get this done depending on where you live. One thing I did leave out, I do have a piece of copper-clad, a double-sided copper-clad PC board here. If I ever want to go in and put polyphasers or make a common ground, there's plenty of room inside for this right here that's in there. So once again, hope you got something out of that. If you have any question about putting it through your wall, my suggestion is go ahead. It only hurts for a little while, and that's when that first drill hits it. But after that first drill hits it, you're committed, and so you'll just go ahead and go all the way through. This is John, W5CYF. Hope to catch you on there. Until then, 73.